Limits of or the responsibility of autonomy are deliberately boxed. So the level four follower truck does not have to understand all different kinds of emergency vehicles, all different kinds of construction zones, etc. by itself. We have a human pair of human eyes in the front truck doing that semantic understanding. And the responsibilities of the autonomy is limited to just stay behind the leader, follow the leader in a safe manner. That enables us to time bug. That enables us to come up with a tractable development and validation for autonomous driving. From there, where we will go? Well, if you look at, again, a convoy, a couple of years down the road, we will have thousands and thousands of convoys with human drivers in the front, but the second trucks driving themselves. And even the lead trucks have the same capabilities and the same hardware as the follower trucks, because we want any truck to be in the lead or in the follower position. So when the lead driver is driving the convoy, they are an economically feasible unit. They are making money. But at the same time, we have the same autonomy system, similar to what Tesla is actually doing. When you are driving a Tesla, you are not driving the Tesla. You are not driving your car for Tesla. You are driving your car for yourself. But Tesla opportunistically looks into what you are doing and use it to validate the autonomy. This is,
and you're collecting a bunch of data, right?
Exactly. That's what we will be doing as well. When the human driver is driving the lead truck, human driver is driving the lead truck, but autonomy is over the shoulders watching what the human driver is doing and comparing it to what it would have done in the same situation. Mm-hmm. That performed at large scale is going to enable us to collect validation data and is going to actually propel us to higher levels of autonomy or towards this individual deployment of autonomy much faster and much safer.